Okay, let's look at selective prime implicants now. So we have seen essential prime implicants, implicants, redundant prime implicants. This is the last one, which is called as selective prime implicants. Now these are the prime implicants which are neither RPIs nor EPIs. They are neither redundant prime implicants, they are neither nor essential prime implicants. Okay, so those kind of groups you have to check, and those are called as selective prime implicants. They may appear in some expressions and may not appear in other. Okay, so it's really means you have to check in the K maps whether they exist or not. Sometimes they occur, sometimes they don't. Okay, so really not necessary that you will find SPI all the time in the K map. So here as an example, three variable K map I have taken, already filled the minterms and already made the pairs. So now these dotted ones are essential prime implicants. You can see that because of this minterm, this has only one option of pairing, that is this minterm, and hence this is a essential prime implicant. So I'll write AB. This group is AB EPI. Okay, similarly this also, because of this minterm, only one option he has to get paired, that's the reason it is essential prime implicants, which is A bar B bar, so EPI. Now if you will look at the other two groups, these are selective prime implicants. Why? Because they are neither they are not redundant prime implicants as well as they are not essential prime implicants. What are the conditions for essential prime implicants? It means minterm because of at least one minterm should be there which has only one option, and that's the only requirement. Means minterm should have only one option. Even if there is one, if more than one, it's fine. Only one option, only one minterm is there who has only one option of pairing, then we call it as essential prime implicants. So these dotted ones are essential prime implicants, we have already showed you. So these guys are not essential prime implicants because you can see this minterm has two options. This minterm has two options, and this minterm also has two options. So nowhere it is essential prime implicants. Similarly, if you will see for redundant prime implicant, each of the minterm has to be a part of essential prime implicant. So you can see that in this group, this guy is a part of essential prime implicant, which is fine. But this guy is not an essential part of essential prime implicant, and hence that's the reason this group is not redundant prime implicant. So this group is not redundant prime implicant, not essential prime implicant, means this group is selective prime implicant. By the way, it is prime implicant. Okay, prime implicant, everyone is prime implicant, but which one is selective prime implicant, redundant prime implicant, or essential prime implicant, you have to check. Okay, so this one we checked, both of them are not there, hence it is selective prime implicants. Similarly, if you will see for this guy, if we will check for essential prime implicant, both the means at least one minterm should be having only one option. But here you can see in this group, both the minterms are having multiple option to pair, and hence this is not essential prime implicant. If you will check for redundant prime implicant, each of the minterm should be part of essential prime implicant. Here you can see this minterm is a part of essential prime implicant, but this minterm is not a part of essential prime implicant, and hence that's the reason this group will be selective prime implicant. Okay, so I hope it is clear that you have to check both the properties. If any one of them will occur, it is not SPI. If both of them will not occur, it is SPI. Okay, so you have to check both of them, means it should not be EPI, it should not be RPI, and the remaining is SPI. It is like left out groups are called as selective prime implicants. So I hope it is clear. By the way, this, they all are prime implicants. They all are prime implicants. And about implicants, each of the minterms you can say are implicants. So 1 2 3 4 5 implicants, 1 2 3 4 groups, so 4 prime implicants, then selective prime implicants are 2, redundant prime implicants are 0, essential prime implicants are 2. Okay, this one and this one. So you saw everything I have calculated. We will see one more example so that you will get better picture. Okay. Okay, now let's look at this example. Here we will try to calculate all of it. Prime implicants, implicants, essential prime implicants, redundant prime implicants, selective prime implicants, everything we will calculate. Okay, so the first thing we will start with implicants. Implicants, if you remember, they were the subset of the main function. So let's say you have function is equal to summation m 1, 2, 3, 4. Then g if you will defining as m 2, just only one single min term, then also g will be called as the implicant of f. Okay, so same thing will apply here. How many min terms are there, just count, and that will be the implicant. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Okay, implicants are 8. What about prime implicants? Best possible groups. Best possible groups I have already marked 1, 2, 3, 4. Total 4 groups. Okay. You can also pair like this. Okay. If you want this, this pairing instead of this pairing, you can also do this pairing. Still, it will be right. And total 4 prime implicants will be there. What about essential prime implicants? So you can see that essential prime implicants are these two guys, this group. And this group, because this min terms are only having one option of pairing, this and this. So which ones are this guy, which is I think A bar C bar D. This is your essential prime implicant. Then the last guy, A B bar D bar. Okay, so this is essential prime implicant. So two essential prime implicants are there. What about redundant prime implicants? So if you remember, redundant prime implicants, they are those groups where each of the min terms should be the part of essential prime implicant. Okay, so these two are the only these two groups are the only essential prime implicants. Okay, so nearby those groups we will find redundant prime implicants most probably. So if you will look this group, this min term is not a part of essential prime implicant, this is. Hence, this will not be a redundant prime implicant. These are essential prime implicant already, and remaining group is this group. So here, if you will see, these three groups are, these three min terms are not a part of essential prime implicants. Hence, redundant prime implicants is 0. Okay, what about selective prime implicants? So the two groups are, these two groups are essential prime implicants. So remaining group we will see. So selective prime implicants means they should neither be redundant prime implicant and essential nor essential prime implicant. So this group, if you will see, this is not redundant prime implicant because this min term is not a part of essential prime implicant, and this group is already not a part of essential part, not a essential prime implicant, because this min term has option, multiple option, and this min term also has multiple option. Okay, so this group is our selective prime implicant. Selective prime implicant. What about this guy? So this group, if you will see, they are not redundant prime implicants. We have seen this min terms are not a part of essential prime implicant, nor they are essential prime implicants because I think this is essential prime implicant. Oh, I forgot actually. So there are three essential prime implicants. You can see that this min term, this min term, this min term has only one option of pairing, and hence this is also essential prime implicant, which says that it is not selective prime implicant. Okay, so selective prime implicants is 1, redundant prime implicants is 0, essential prime implicants is 3, prime implicants are 4, and implicants are 8. So you can see that the total of SPI and EPI is prime implicant. Total 4 prime implicants we have, and among prime implicants only there will be selective prime, redundant prime, or essential prime implicants. Okay, so I hope it is properly cleared. we will apply the same technique on other example. One more example I'll take, and there I'll apply the same technique. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's look at this example here. This we have already seen. I'll write the group names. This group is A bar, B bar, C bar. Then this group is A bar, B, D. Second, third is this group, which is A, C, D. Okay, so same thing we'll do. We will first find prime implicants, prime implicants, essential prime implicants, everything we will calculate. So implicant, just like before, count the minterms 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They all will be the subset of main function. So total number of implicants is 6. How many prime implicants are there? So total number of prime implicants are best possible groups. So total 3 groups you have. So they are prime implicants as well. Okay, total 3 groups. Then what about essential prime implicants? So essential prime implicant, you can see that because of this minterm and this minterm, this group and this group is essential essential prime implicants. So 2 essential prime implicants, because these 2 minterms are having only one option, which is this and this, and that's the reason this group says essential prime implicant. What about redundant prime implicants? So redundant prime implicant, if you will see, redundant prime implicant is those prime implicants where each of the minterms should be part of essential prime implicants. Okay, so here you can see this group is the only remaining one. These 2 are already essential prime implicant. So you can see none of the minterms are part of essential prime implicant. So hence this is 0. And what about selective prime implicant? So this will be selective prime implicant, this group, because each of the minterms are not a part of essential prime implicant, and plus they have multiple options, so that's why they are not essential prime implicants. Multiple option of pairing, this guy has this and this, and this guy has this and this, so that's the reason this group is not this group is selective prime implicants, not essential prime or redundant prime implicant. So total 2 plus 1 3 is total 3 prime implicants. Okay, so they all are prime implicants, but these 2 are essential prime implicants, EPI, and this is selective prime implicant. Okay, so this may occur, or these 2 guys may occur or may not occur, okay, in the solution. Really depends upon the K-map, but you know how to check all of it. Now you know about implicants, prime implicants, essential prime implicants, redundant prime implicants, selective prime implicants. Whenever it is being asked, you can now answer it. You just be have to careful, don't mess up with definitions. You have to keep in your head. Sometimes you will get confused between redundant prime and selective prime, which one is what. So be clear with definitions and you will be able to find everything. If I'll find more examples, I'll cover it. Okay.